the recent COVID-19 spike has made it a scarce resource for mankind. Normally, a critical patient can consume about 5 liters of oxygen per minute, but in intensive care units, an amount can go as high as 40 liters per unit. In this special report, Halson Kagure brings us to a speed on what actually it means to be on life support for a week amidst the crisis of oxygen in different health facilities across the country.
Free oxygen is available to all at sea level, says radiation expert Stephen McGinn in one of his brain quotes. But this does not apply to this young female patient gasping for oxygen at Mara Regional Referral Hospital. Asingere, not Harinlem, has spent almost a week here, and at every minute, Babawena, her brother, not real names, sits next to her seatbed to offer comfort. As medics on duty come in to monitor her response to oxygen, the frightened brother is uncertain of when they will be free.
The tube is not removed at all. Now even today she has been a very strong that oxygen. For short course, he uses a bucket to get, that's what they told her, to be an oxygen for the full day. He should have removed it at all.
Thoughts of when she will be discharged seems to dominate her life, but she hasn't gathered courage to speak. Perhaps she also feels for the unwanted safety of her intimate brother, her closest caretaker. Besides Asingere, this woman, who is in her advanced age, has also been on life support machines for a while. She too is a COVID patient. The normal oxygen levels in the body usually range from 95% to 100%, but hers is as low as 60%.
Require a very high amount of oxygen to, you know, to supplement them to go to normal levels of oxygen, like I've said before. So that is the scenario that we see. So somebody can enter normally, and so for you, if you're looking at it if you're looking at him as a layman, you actually think that they're actually okay. But if I look at them as a doctor and I take their oxygen levels, they are actually low.
Averagely, such category of patients can consume as high as 40 liters of oxygen per minute while in intensive care unit.
So in that instance, we give medications to help prevent that effect from happening, but also prevent what they call blood clotting. Yeah, there's a lot of blood clotting in these COVID patients, and therefore we give them medication to prevent blood clotting. We give them medication to prevent the body from attacking itself, for as far as we know now.
In fact, medics have observed that most CT scan tests conducted on lungs of such patients show that such organs have body fluids on lungs that come as a result of the body attacking itself.
And there's things in the body which look like that spike protein. And the body attacks all that. The body attacks all that. And that's why you see. And so in the lungs, there are areas in the lungs which have the cells which look like that spike protein, and the body still attacks. So we give them steroids to prevent that from happening.
On a daily basis, 2 oxygen plants at Barra Regional Referral Hospital can produce about 400 cylinders, but preventive maintenance is critical since spare parts are shipped from overseas.
Parts, actually, some we are out due to overworking, so we are looking at delivering good percentage of oxygen to the patient. So we make sure that in 2 days we test the concentration of oxygen from the plant.
However, it should be noted that the more the machine runs without resting, the more chances of breaking down. This would put the hospital in critical times.
The private sector has put a plant in town which is big, which you also see. So the oxygen, I imagine another person will also maybe put another plant, I don't know. But all these are geared towards making sure that there is enough oxygen.
The reality of scarcity of oxygen cuts across all public facilities, and at Mbara Referral, a truck is always readily available to transport oxygen cylinders for refilling.
There are refillings for different hospitals, different districts. As for now, Port Kota has been here. Mbara Referral Regional Hospital has been here for oxygen. Kisoro Hospital has been here for oxygen.
This is BM Steel, a private oxygen plant that refills oxygen cylinders for both government and private facilities in southwestern Uganda. This plant, which has been operational for less than a month, has the production capacity of 100 liters amidst challenges.
Because we also have overhead costs to be able to pay. I mean, remember, we're giving free oxygen, but at the end of the day, we need to pay our power bills, we need to pay our staff, we need to buy spares so that we can ensure that we're working.
For the case of private facilities, each cylinder is refilled at 50,000 shillings, but plant owners are already decrying power outages as a hindrance. This is in the wake of the Minister of Health plans to allocate 600 billion shillings to solve the problem.